demonstrate some of the new capability for creating turn features added at EdgeCam 2014 R2. Looking in from a turn perspective, notice that this part's machined from a casting. And so for finished machining requirements, we're going to need to machine remove material from the front face and shoulder of this part in a turning center. The Features ribbon provides access to EdgeCam's Feature Finder command, which is a great command, and it will generate many of the turn cross sections as well as milled holes quickly for us. However, many users with turning centers also have situations where it's desirable to create our own features ourselves using something like the Turn Profile command. So this interactive feature recognition tool has always provided ability to create turn features using faces. So if I create one for the groove area and I'll label this groove and press OK, I can go and select individual faces that make up the part. So this is long-standing capability that EdgeCam's always had. And in order to use this feature recognition command, you simply need to choose the individual faces that make up the feature and off you go. However, for some complicated parts, which may have many fillets, chamfers, or face details along the shape, that could be an extremely lengthy process to create, and the new ability gives us the profile turn option. Notice that we have options to extend the turn feature. When we press OK, the prompt is to select the body for manual turn, so we'll select the finished part as the solid to find the turn feature from. And the first thing that EdgeCam does is it displays a cross-section of the entire turn feature of the part. It's important to note that that turn cross-section is accurate to the revolved shape of the part, so that is our true minimum turn cross-section. The readout line asks us to select the start and end points, and so we'll go and zoom in, and I'll left-click on the chamfer as my starting point, and then I'll go click on the back shoulder here as my final point, and we can from here toggle to the other end of the feature with the left button to have the feature represent a different collection of material or keep the one we have here. That looks great, so we'll go ahead and finish, and that quickly creates a turn feature for us that represents the entire cross section of that area. That's immediately machinable using EdgeCam's manual feature creation tools, where users can select the tool they wish to use and then build the appropriate turning cycle. For users interested in the more automatic approach of using the machining strategies and process intelligence, we can take this turn feature and add some information using the properties window. So with the properties window on, with this feature, we can add to it that its direction is a front feature and its location is as a turn feature. And with just that little bit of additional information saved into the part, when I go to manufacture mode, we now have ability to use planning board. Planning board promptly suggests machining strategies for this, and I can apply the toolpath to quickly create the outline of the turning. And the user would at this point ensure that it did pick the tool you intend to use, and that the feed rates and spindle speeds in the rough turning cycle are correct. I want to point out here, as you look at the part, that the turning shape is correct. The turning toolpath is correct to the part we're working on. We can also simulate this and see a prediction of the material removal. As we play and see the turret move into position, we not only see the out-of-station tools with EdgeCam's machine simulation, but we also see how this tool removes the material from that part to give us a great prediction of what the CNC code is going to do when we send it to the CNC machine. We can see the tool is allowed to go into the back angle of this, and if we want to eliminate that, then we could edit the rough turn cycle, and we could tell it on the cut strategies that it is not permitted to dive into undercut regions. And so now our tool path heads straight across that groove area as if it does not exist, just like it would be able to do with a feature created using the more traditional feature find command that a user might be familiar with. Let's explore what happens with interactive turn features when there's a design change. Before we reload the new solid, notice that the part is in its current configuration has a shoulder that's a common shoulder diameter that's interrupted by a groove, and that the angles of the groove appear to be 45 degrees. We'll turn on the Features window, and then working from the Features window, we'll reload the solid model that we've been using and replace it with a different solid. When we do that, the first thing that EdgeCam does is to check the features and evaluate how the features are impacted by the design change. In this case, we can see that both the groove and the turn features are impacted. When we go over to the sequence window, notice that the rough turn cycle is currently shown in red, but the toolpath has not yet been updated to the current part geometry. At this stage, the user would evaluate whether the machining process will work, and since it will work, I'm simply going to regenerate it. If there were changes that need to be made, we could also make those changes at this time. Notice though, the toolpath color is still red even though the toolpath has been updated. And when we hover the mouse over the rough turn cycle, there's a tooltip that comes up that explains the reason for the red coloring. The rough turn cycle is targeted to machine the turn feature, and the turn feature has been changed. This is simply a visual flag to help the user identify which cycles are impacted by the features that are modified. In this case, all that we have to do is accept the changed features, and the red flag color is removed from the rough turning cycle. We also want to point out that in cases where it may be desirable to recreate the feature, you can edit the feature, and the feature contains a chord input checkbox. And when you turn on chord input and press OK, you'll then be allowed to go and reconstruct the feature so that it represents the geometry that you have in mind after a new part design.